so if we talk about components of digital marketing, so as I said, like we'll be broadly talking about four components. And when we talk about four components, we are actually talking in the sense search engine SEO is abbreviated as search engine optimization. And mostly we'll be talking about Google because Google is only the leftover search engine as of now in current scenario broadly if we talk about. Of course, Yahoo is there, MSN is there, and other platforms are also there. But primarily we use Google and in and around we do Google. So search engine optimization, Google paid ad management, social media marketing, and then lead generation. Lead generation we'll be talking about, email marketing as well and a few other components. So these are broadly four components of digital marketing that we will be discussing across all 4 or 5 days during this session. Now, next it comes as an overview, if we say. So in case we see, in terms of definition, so search engine optimization is basically, I will define it, it's not written, search engine optimization is basically anything that you do to make sure that your site starts ranking in Google or starts ranking in search engine is called search engine optimization. So optimization is a continuous process. It's never that it's an end line or it's an end result of it. Right? So you have to continuously keep on working on making some improvisation of your website in the keyword, in content, in various other things that we'll be discussing. So once you search something on a Google, you'll get something like this. This is a Google toolbar. So someone searched credit card processing and these are the results that will appear. So the results which are appearing in the red box, these are sometimes being called sponsored, sometimes being, I'm like, you will, in current scenario, you'll be able to see ad which is written at the top. So credit card processing or these things in the top two or three listings are coming as a Google paid result. So that is basically from the Google advertising. Now, rest of the things, whatever you see in the blue box, which is coming with the natural listing, and that is because of search engine optimization work. So more and more we'll be talking in today's session, we'll be talking about something which is coming after. I'll also activate a few things so that we can see it. So you can see this mouse with this. So we'll be talking about this section, how we will be able to implement, how we can optimize our website so that our website starts ranking in Google with various keywords. Now, why SEO is so important for marketers? Now, if you see this section, which we call it reverse L. We call it reverse L. Now this reverse L is basically a place. So extreme top left is the place on any, whether you open a book or you open a website or you open a mobile, this is the section where you get more attention. Now this image, I have grabbed it from Google and it is popularly based on how our mind react once we see something. So I'm not going to go in the technicality of creation of this image, but I'll be more talking about. So since lot of attention will be only there in the top left corner or in the first half of the page, so most of the companies are dying that their somehow their ranking, their image or their website should start ranking in this part of the search engine result page. So search engine optimization pulls more traffic. Now you can see here it is written search engine pulls SEO pulls more traffic than PPC. So what is PPC? We have not discussed it, but I'll share that to you. PPC is pay per click. Google ad, the when we advertise something by paying something on a Google, that particular concept is called PPC, pay per click. For every click, you need to pay something to Google. It works in simple layman language. It works in the format of prepaid talk time, that if you want to make a call, the number of calls that you will be making, it will get deducted from your account. So if you have deposited 1,000 rupees to Google based on various keywords, one click, there is a chance it will deduct 10 rupees, 15 rupees, 25 rupees or 30 rupees or a dollar and a half or something like that. So it depends based on various keyword will have various other kind of things. So it will basically take those things. So why SEO is important? Because it pulls more traffic. And for PPC, Google paid ad, your ad will disappear if your budget gets exhausted. And whereas in search engine optimization, once it starts ranking, it will be there for certain time. It will take certain time to reach to this level on the first page of Google. But if it reaches, it will be there for some time. It may be a couple of weeks, it may be a couple of months, or sometimes even longer. So it takes time for you to rank in the first page of Google, but it remains there. So it is better than PPC if you start getting ranking. Now, natural listings are perceived to be non-biased. This is something which is quite important. Now, what do you mean by non-biased? It's basically if your website is of Google parameter, then your website will start ranking in Google. No one can influence. Even if you make certain payment in your paid advertisement, if your paid ad is running and you are doing SEO, even if you are making a payment to Google, your organic listing or natural listing will not get affected. SEO ranking will not get affected because of the payment that you are making to Google. So it is natural and non-biased. It completely comes based on Google parameter, based on Google algorithm. So Google has set some parameter, some qualifying metrics. Based on that, a website can rank, and that we call it Google algorithm. Third important point is, SEO gives better return on investment than any marketing medium. These are the advantages of SEO. Fourth, no bidding wars. Now what happens? If you are putting some money to Google and say you are advertising for, you are manufacturer of leather products. You are manufacturing leather bags. So I am manufacturer number one, you are manufacturer number two. So I bid on leather bag manufacturer or leather bag exporter or leather bag trader in India. So for that, if I am bidding for 45 rupees, you will come into picture and you will start bidding for 55 rupees. Now what will happen? To reach at the top of the page in paid advertisement, there is always a war, right? Whereas in search engine optimization, there is nothing called that kind of war. So no bidding competition will be there. So your budget is not getting exhausted. It's only you start working on your website, and your website will be start ranking in the Google. So there will be no bidding war, and there is a no chance of click frauds in SEO. It helps to create online brands. Now what happens if you are visible? I am searching for leather bag manufacturer in India. Say website abcleather.com is coming. I'm also searching for leather handbags in India or in Hyderabad or in Telangana or in Andhra Pradesh or in Delhi somewhere. And there is a abcleather.com is appearing. So what happens? User will be used to of seeing those particular brand name, website. So more and more this will be visible, brand will be more strong. So when brand will be more strong, it helps to create a stronger online brand presence on a search engine because of search engine optimization. All right. In terms of, there are certain generic advice. This is out of the context, but it is good for madam, for you also, Anu madam, for you also, for Taufik and for Aleen, for all of us to understand on what parameter budget for SEO is being defined. Now, say there are variety of keyword selection parameter. Now, if, as I said, as I have given you the example of leather purse manufacturer or leather bag manufacturer. Right. Now, if I am, there will be a keyword like, say, for example, I'll write it over here, a keyword called leather bag manufacturer. This kind of keyword we call it generic keyword. There is a possibility prior to this, they can also have one more keyword called bag manufacturer. More generic. This is little leather bag manufacturer. Then we go for men leather bag. Next level, woman bag. Right? It could be right. So I'm just giving an example. These could be few of the examples, and we call it, these are the generic keywords. But next to this, there will be location based keywords. Say, for example, leather bag manufacturers in India. Second could be leather bag in Hyderabad. Okay, so these, now you just try to see the variations what I am trying to create. We will explain this particular thing based on this. Now, how to estimate what will be the baseline of SEO budget? So understand, if we make a search of bag manufacturer in Google, it means to say all bag manufacturers, be it leather bag manufacturer, be it cloth bag manufacturer, or plastic bag manufacturers, or jute bag manufacturer, all bag manufacturers listing will come for a global level. Getting me? So for a global level, everything will come. So competition is very huge. So this is this will be very, very competitive keyword. KW is basically for keyword. That's what we'll be writing. Now, this is of two word. So shorter keywords are very competitive. It will be, and it will be tough to achieve in shorter time frame. Bigger the keyword, so leather bag manufacturers will have little less competition, but still it will have competition because it is generic. Now I am not saying anything. I am just explaining you what you have to do. You can make a note of these keywords and you start doing a Google. You will see the numbers that will vary, right? So these could be little more competitive. Third level of men leather bag manufacturer, competitive. Women bag manufacturers, it will be again very competitive because all kind of bags will be coming. Women leather bag manufacturers, it will be competitive. Now, what do we mean by competitive and very, very competitive? Means search results. If you do a search in a Google, you'll get more search results. If you do a Google by second keyword, it will be little lesser. So that's why. Now, if you come to this keyword, which is leather bag manufacturers in India, it is region based keyword. Region based keyword. And this is location based. And this last one, it is hyperlocation. So these are variety of keywords for one particular website, which we call it leather bag manufacturer. Now, if we roughly, I'm saying, it's not exact, but roughly I'm saying, if you are going with keywords like this, leather bag manufacturer or men leather bag manufacturer, because here you don't have region or location mentioned. So this is a global keyword. So global keywords are competitive or very, very competitive or very, very, very tough to achieve ranking sometime. So these things will be tough to achieve. So tougher keywords, you can make it a calculation like, say for a website, abcleather.com, you want to choose 10 keywords. And all these 10 keywords are something like either bag manufacturer or like leather bag manufacturer or men leather bag manufacturer. If you have, right? So if you have these kind of keywords, then you can make a note of, say, approximately that to achieve ranking, you have to put certain efforts, you have to do some activity, and that may cost you somewhere around approximately 1500 rupees or little lesser or little more, 1500 rupees per keyword per month kind of thing. So if you are going with leather bag manufacturer kind of keyword, so what will happen? 1500 rupees multiplied by 10 equal to 15,000 will be budget for tentative budget. It may go, if agency is charging you 20,000 or it is charging you 16,000, 18,000, it is reasonably okay. But if agency is charging you 5,000 to give a ranking like these kind of keywords, of course, it's not practically possible. And something is messy over there. So don't trust very cheap services who are giving very cheap services at very cheaper price. So this is a rough calculation. Now, if you are going with the keywords like regional keyword, so it will be reduced because competition will be less. Less number of manufacturers will come. Less number of search results will come. So it may go to a level of 1200 rupees per keyword. If you are going with leather bag manufacturer in Hyderabad, that may go up to 800 or 900 kind of thing. If you go like leather bag manufacturers in Banjara Hills, Hyderabad, India, which is very hyper local, very hyper located, where geo map and other things will be incorporated. So that kind of keywords will be much cheaper. It may cost you 500 or 600 rupees per keyword. Now you have a question, why there is a cost when this is free, this is organic? I'm telling you this, that if you are doing it yourself and if you are billing it to any company, these could be the parameter on which you can understand how much you should bill to a company. Being a search engine analyst, when you are making a business proposal, you should understand what should be the budget that you should give it to the client. To understand that for very competitive keyword or regional kind of keyword, you can charge ranging between 15,000 to 20,000 rupees. It's okay. If very, very competitive keywords like leather bag manufacturers, that kind of keyword, if someone is charging you 25,000 rupees, in between 20 to 25,000 rupees, reasonably okay for 10 keywords, reasonably okay, little higher side, but okay. But if someone is saying that in 7,000, they will give you, don't trust, it is not possible. Similarly, if you are going for little lower level of keywords, then your budget will go down. So you as a business analyst have to understand what is the, I'm like, we discussed about attention, IDA model, attention, interest, desire, and final action. So based on demography and the customer understanding from a client, you need to understand whether for your clients or for you, whether regional keywords are important, location-based local keywords are important, or hyper-local keywords are important, or generic keywords are important. Even if you are exporter, you want to grow it to the international level, still people are searching more on region-based or location-based search result companies rather than going on a global level of companies. So these are some of the parameters that you should understand. Now, whether to invest in SEO first or whether to go for a PPC first. Now, to understand that, what I will say, as a startup, at its initial level, you have to do a blending approach. So what you have to do, you invest on some of the keywords of SEO, little bit you invest on a paid campaign of Google, so that what will happen, Google paid campaign will give you instant result. So you will get instant inquiries. There could be instant conversions. And once conversion will be there, you can put back on your improvisation of your website, on improvisation of various other factors that Google considers. It's quite critical for SEO to perform on a website. So that we can do. So it's a blending approach. Say, for example, you have a 20,000 rupees budget, 15,000 you invest on search engine optimization, 5,000 you invest on pay-per-click. Now, why I'm saying more to SEO and less to PPC? Because slowly, what happens after 2 months or 3 months time frame, your SEO will start giving you result. And once SEO starts giving you result, cost per lead generation, cost per lead, CPL will be very cheap, and then you will be performing better. So slowly, your SEO budget will go down, and you can invest that amount in a PPC, or you can increase number of keywords for your SEO, and this will optimize your performance of your website. Third important thing. So third important thing is how much it takes to see SEO result. So for SEO, it takes sometimes 2 months, 3 months. Keywords like bag manufacturers may take 6 months or even more. Keywords like leather bag manufacturer in India may take 3 months time or 4 months time. Keywords like leather bag manufacturer in Hyderabad may take a month time or so. Keywords like leather bag manufacturers in Banjar Hills, Hyderabad may take very, very lesser time. So hyperlocation based on, so what you do, you choose some of the keywords in a hyperlocation, some of the keywords as a location, some of the keywords as a regional. So create a variety of it and then you start promoting it. So in 6 months time frame, you'll have enough of the keywords ranking in the Google first page. All right. Oh, so this is not going. I'll just remove this first.
Sir, I have a question, sir. What is this KW and competitive?
KW is keyword. I've written KW in the short form. Competitive means the moment you search bag manufacturer in Google, you will get more number of results, right? Uh-huh. And if you search leather bag manufacturer, you'll get little lesser number of keywords because you have added all other bag manufacturers like jute bag, plastic bag, artificial bag, or flower bag, or other bags. So it will differentiate from there, right?
So in PPC, will there be more demand for the the higher rated keywords, or there's nothing like that?
PPC gives you control of, without adding location or hyperlocation, still you can target hyperlocation people. You can actually run a campaign in a particular location. Say I want to run a campaign only for Banjara Hills, for example. Mm-hmm. Right? For that, I need not to put a keyword called Banjara Hills in the keyword.
Oh, okay.
Right. So it will be leather bag manufacturer, woman leather bag manufacturer, men leather bag manufacturer. I want to run it for Banjara Hills. I can run it only for Banjara Hills. If I want to run it for Hyderabad, only that keyword. If someone will be searching leather bag manufacturer in Hyderabad, still our results will come. If someone is searching in Banjara Hills, still our results will come. If someone is searching for leather bag manufacturer on a national level, if we make our campaign active for a national level, our ad will appear. So not necessarily that you have to put location, hyperlocation, or region in paid campaign, because Google gives you a liberty to select region where you want to publish your ad.
Okay, got it.
These are something related to only only for SEO purpose.
Okay.
These are only for the SEO purpose, right?
All right.
So now there is a tool called Google Keyword Planner. I have just taken a screenshot of it. So what it does now, we are not experts of, say for example, we are not experts which keyword will perform, which keyword will not perform. So to understand that, Google has given a platform called Google Keyword Planner. Right? So what happens if you put a keyword over here in this search bar, right? It gives you, so this screen is basically related to hotel. So if I am searching hotel, Google started giving us what are the popular keywords which are being searched in Google. And these are based on the paid campaign. So if in paid campaign more searches are happening, of course it means that for organic searches also, these keywords will be performing. So this is an interface by which you get broad idea about which keyword you should choose to optimize for your website, either for a paid campaign or for organic campaign. Organic means SEO, something you are not paying any to Google, but still your website ranks. Paid campaign means Google advertisement. So if you search hotel, these are some of the options that Google has given. Hotel New York City Hotels, New York Hotels. Now you can see this as a complete green bar means it's a very competitive, means it's a full of competition. Lot of websites are actually trying to get top ranking in Google by this keyword. So it is very, very competitive. And search volume is also reasonably okay. What is search volume? Search volume is number of people doing search in your locality for that particular keyword. Okay, so that is search volume. So based on this, now for if you are in a hotel business, so it is giving Hotel New York. Then after that, it's a London hotel. After that, it's a Dubai hotel. Now I have a hotel in India. Now these hotels are not of, these keywords are not of my use. So what I will do, I'll go and search for hotels Delhi or hotels in India. It could be 3-star hotel, best property, best hotel. So those kind of combinations Google will start showing and it will see how competitive it is. So as I mentioned in the last screen, competitive, very, very competitive. So something which is completely in the green bar, complete bar is green. So that is very, very competitive. Something which is less, little lesser competitive. So you can see this is little lesser competitive. Similarly, search volume, right? So these search volume are sometimes in thousands. So if you are choosing a keyword which are having good search volume, so what will happen? You start ranking in Google and then your website will get more traffic. Once more traffic will come, you will automatically start getting more number of inquiries. So this is just an interface. We'll also go through proper interface of Google and then we can also do some testing how it actually shows results. Now to understand, now we are moving towards how to understand if you are doing a competitive analysis of a website. As this screenshot is basically from Internet Explorer, right. Google had a extension called PageRank. Earlier they used to have it. Now they have scrapped it because more and more people are using Chrome. So they have not kept it very open. But earlier in Google toolbar, there was something called PageRank. Now what is PageRank? It has nothing to do with ranking that you are seeing. If you are searching something in a Google, it's not like that. It's not for that. It's basically a quality score that Google is giving out of 10, how quality, what kind of quality that this website carries. So this Make My Trip website, when we had taken this screenshot, little older one, but what happens, this page rank, it shows that yes, it's six, almost six, more than 50% of it. So it's a quite good. Apple website of Apple is almost 8 or 9, or MSN almost 10, similarly, right? So higher the page rank, Google has given a score. So higher the score out of 10, it is ranging from 0 to 10. So what happens, based on certain qualitative parameters Google gives these rankings. So it could be one of the parameter to understand how competitive, or if you are competing with XYZ website, you need to understand what is their quality parameter, how Google has rated them, right? But since it is not visible on Chrome, so you may ignore it, but this was a crucial factor in earlier days. So that we call it Google PageRank. Now next important thing is there is something called, you can see over here, link:makemytrip.com. So if you want to search for a competitiveness or how popular a website is, what you have to do, you have to, in a Google search bar, you have to write link: and then domain name. Don't put any gap at all. And then you make a search. The moment you will make a search, you will be able to see how many websites are linking back to this particular website. Now, what does this, how important it is? It is very important because this is something which is going to decide that whether your website is important in the reference of Google or not. Google considers your website important or not. For that, you have to list your website at various other websites as well. And this is something on which mostly it happens. I'll explain you in a very simple format. Say, what happens in election? The person who gets more vote, he actually wins the election, right? So similarly, more websites are linked back to your website. Qualitative websites are linking back to your website. Your importance will increase in the eyes of Google, and Google will start showing respect for your website, in the sense it will start pushing your website little upper and it will give you ranking. So this is one parameter on which you can also understand how strengthful or how stronger competitive websites are. Now, next to this is site colon domain name, makemytrip.com. We are giving example of makemytrip. You can take example of any other thing. So site colon makemytrip. This will give you a number of pages of that particular website listed in Google. Now, what happens if your website is having 100 pages and you made a search of it and site colon your own website.com? Now you saw that it's only 65 pages are listed over here. Now what happens to rest of the 35 pages? So curiosity will start. That means to say Google has not considered it of quality, or Google bot has not reached to that level. So your work will start working. You will start working towards that. That we will take little later. But I'm just explaining, these are few of the things that to understand how a website is strong, whether a website is strong, stronger or very strong. So to understand those things, these are few things which we have to take into consideration. Now, henceforth, moving forward, now we will be discussing about SEO, components of SEO. So there are two components of SEO. One, we call it on-page optimization. Second, we call it off-page optimization. So what is on-page optimization? Any changes that you are making in your website. Any changes that you are making in your website. Whether you are improving content, whether you are inserting keyword, whether you are making any modification in the code, everything, anything and everything that you are working on your website to make sure that your website ranks better in Google, that we call it on-page optimization. And anything out of your website where you are not making any changes on your website, that we call it off-page optimization. You will understand it better in a subsequent slides. Now, keyword selection is the crux of whole SEO process. I should not say only the SEO process, it's the crux of complete digital marketing. Whether you decide which hashtag to write, or whether you decide which what at the rate in Twitter, if you are there, what to write in Instagram, if you are there, what to put a tag on it. So everything is in and around driven by keywords. So right kind of keywords can help you to reach your right kind of results. And if wrongly chosen keyword, it may break your complete success. So don't leave, even if you as an entrepreneur is outsourcing your website to be done, SEO to be done by any of an agency, don't just leave it. Understand what kind of keyword that he has selected for your website. Or you as a search engine analyst, understand whether your keywords are appropriate enough to give a successful result to the client or not. So you need to understand that. Now, on-page optimization factor. See, this is a page layout structure. If you open a website, any website, you go to Chrome or you go to Internet Explorer, wherever you go, if you open www. Say any website, I should say www.indianexpress.com, news website called indianexpress.com. There also you will be able to see some of the things which will be coming at the top. Now if you say you open amazon.in or amazon.com, you'll be able to see something over here. So these things Now, why this is very important for SEO? Because if you do some search in Google, the results which comes in Google, you must have seen first line is coming in a green color, which if you take your mouse over there, you click on it, it takes you to the website. So that is called title tag. And you have a limitation of somewhere between 55 to 60 characters that you should maintain in that. So keeping that in mind, whatever you will put over there, that will be coming in the first line of a Google search result. Based on that, user will define or find whether he should click your website or not. So you get only a limitation of 55 characters to make sure that your target audience clicks on your website and reach to your website. So this is very crucial and very important. So the way that we have looked for a keyword, so what we have to do, we have to insert certain keywords in title tag. So that's what it is. Next, we will see header tags. To make any report, any kind of report if we make, or PPT we make, or Word document we make, there are various header tags. I'm like something that you're writing in the bold, little higher, little bolder and a bigger thing as a title. Then you have little lesser, then you have second level title, then you have third level. So what happens, Google also pays very important attention on what kind of content you have kept in header tags. So H1 to H6, you can play around on your web page. And H1, H2, H3 are the prominent tags that you can use. But you can play around up to H6 tag. There is no problem at all. H1 is the highest prioritized key, tag, header tag, which Google will see. And what it defines? It actually defines what this page is all about. You can see this page is talking about debt settlement. Can reduce your credit card debt for more than 50%. So what it is talking about, it is talking about debt settlement. It is talking about credit card debt. So these are two important things this particular page will be talking about. Now, this is there in the H1 tag. So Google will understand this page is all about this. But during this page, if these keywords are not being repeated properly, so Google understand that this is related to debt settlement. And your content is not showing any importance to that. So that is mismatching. So users will not like it. So what will happen? Bounce rate will be higher. So higher will be the bounce rate. People will come. They don't find content interesting and they will go out. So Google also considers that. So what you have to do, you have to write an engaging content so that users read those content and stay on the page. Longer they stay on the page, there will be a chance that they will, your website will be ranking better in Google search result page. In H2, you can also see here also they have written credit card debt settlement. So debt settlement is over here. And then debt consolidation is also coming. Bankruptcy or alternatives available. So all these things are talking about how to settle down your debts in case there is something which is available. Right? So we have to put header tags very prominently on the, all of the pages. If you have 10 pages, try to put header tags separately for all pages. And this will create strength for your pages. Now, next important thing is like, we have to optimize content. Now, as I was saying, debt consolidation or debt settlement, you can see these are the keywords which are in their box. Right? So what you have to do, you have to maintain, you can see what I have written, good content with correct keyword density. So what do you mean by keyword density? Keyword density means number of times you have repeated a particular keyword in every 100 words. Say for example, debt consolidation. In 100 words paragraph, you have to repeat it 2 times, not more than this. You can repeat it, but what will happen? Over optimization or over inculcation of these keywords may damage your reputation in Google's parameter, and you may be considered as doing some gray technique or some black technique to make more strength to your website. So don't do that. Maintain reasonably okay kind of keyword density, 2% or sometimes less than that. So what do you mean by that? So if you are putting up a 100 word paragraph, so you have to use it 2 times. If you are putting a 500 words paragraph, you can use 10 times. But debt consolidation is one keyword. So you can use 10 times this keyword. Whereas credit card debt settlement is another keyword. So what will happen? You can use again similar number of times this. So what will happen? This weightage for this weightage of this page will increase because it is more or less talking about debt consolidation and debt settlement. So what you have to do, you write content in a very organic way and try to insert various keywords related to that particular page at in such a way that it looks very natural. Don't make it very, very gaudy kind of thing that it looks very artificial and people don't like it. Say, for example, I ask you to introduce yourself, right? And you may start, say, if I ask Aleem to introduce, he may say that myself, Aleem, doing ABC job in so-and-so company. Myself, Aleem, qualification is BTech graduate. Myself, Aleem, son of so-and-so. Myself, Aleem, resident of Hyderabad. What will happen? People will say, Aleem, we understand you are Aleem, but talk little more. So what happens? First time you will say myself, Aleem, and then followed by that, you will talk about yourself. Now, what is Aleem? Who is Aleem? So Aleem is going to talk about his profession. Aleem is going to talk about his parents. Aleem may talk about his skill sets. He may talk about his hobby. So there are a lot of things in and around Aleem. So what all these things are defining? These things are defining about parameters of Aleem. So if someone is searching for skill sets that Aleem carries, so his page should appear. That's what the context is. So that's how we have to work on incorporating relevant number of keywords in relevant way so that you optimize the content. And this parameter, we call it content optimization. Then file name. You can see internal pages of a website has some extension like about.php, like services.html, right? So we recommend don't put about, services or these kind of keywords as a file name. You try to incorporate keyword over there. What will happen? These keywords will create good impact. Number of times you get an option from Google saying that if your keyword is there in the title tag, it is good. If your keyword is there in the header tag, it is good. If your keyword is there in the content with decent keyword density, very good. Now you have a keyword in URL. It's also a positive point. So this also you have to understand. There, most of the time, a developer develops it like about, and they will say services one, services two, the product one, product two, or just like that, they will give the naming of the web pages. Don't get carried away by that. You make sure that you have every page has proper naming so that it creates an impact on in a Google ranking and your pages will be ranking better in Google. Next important thing is Google never crawls images. So images Google will not read. What Google reads? Google reads file name of the image, or there is something called alt tag. So what happens? If there is an image, you take a mouse over there. If I take a mouse over here, something like that, eliminate unsecured debt. So this is called alt tag, image alt tag. So you have an option. This image will be named most of the time. Developers say image1.jpg, image2.jpg, image3.jpg. This will not give you ranking. If ask developer to put some keyword for that, say for example, debtconsolidation.jpg. debtsettlement.jpg, JPG, credit card debt settlement, credit card debt settlement alternative. So what will happen if someone is searching these terms in Google, your images will also start ranking. So that is the advantage if you do it properly. And if you have alt tags, so Google takes these things and it will give a ranking. So all these things actually impact your Google ranking. Next important thing is like sitemap. So what is sitemap? Say for example, I'll narrate in a very simple way. You visit a multi-story or very a gated community, and there is block A, block B, block C, block D. Every block has sub-blocks, like some naming conventions are there. Ganga, Jamuna, Saraswati, Kaveri, this kind of thing could be there, or it could be in the name of any other popular places or any other places. So what happens? You go to the gate and ask for where this place is. So he will say go straight, turn right, or go straight, turn left, and then again right, you will find there is a block in that you take a lift, go to second floor. So what he is doing, he is actually helping you to navigate to the right destination, right? Because you don't know where to go. Similarly, same thing can happen for a user which is coming to your website. So there is no human being over there, so he will not be able to ask. So what we recommend, you to put some kind of sitemap. We recommend to put some kind of sitemap on your website which lists all pages available and make that particular sitemap prominently visible in your footer of your website. So what will happen if someone is not able to find any services that you are dealing with? He will click on the sitemap, navigate through it, and then he will reach to the right page. It is good from a user's perspective. So if your page is having this kind of thing, of course, this also creates some impact on Google searching and ranking. This is from a user's perspective. And second important parameter is you make sure that this page being indexed by Google. If this page being indexed by Google, all pages which are listed on this page will also get indexed by Google. So that is another advantage, right? So try to understand, try to make a very comprehensive list of your sitemap so that all pages of your websites are listed over there. Next, we talk about Google XML sitemap. Now, what is Google XML sitemap? This is basically converting whole website into XML sitemap, and then you submit it to Google Webmaster or Google Search Console saying that these are the pages that Google should visit on what frequency? On a daily basis or on a weekly basis or on a fortnightly basis, you can actually recommend that. Based on the kind of changes that you are making on your website, Google bot will come, they will visit you. What you have to do, you have to create this and then you have to submit it in a Webmaster or Search Console. Earlier it was being called Webmaster, now it is being called Search Console. So what you have to do, you will be submitting, you will create an account. You only have to do what you require, Gmail account. So with your Gmail account, you can create a property and you can add Webmaster. So what you will do, you will be adding a website and over there you will be adding your sitemap.xml. Once you submit it, Google bot fetches all the pages, and in case they find any problem in your page, it will give this kind of, you can see, it will give this kind of, these kind of details. So when this page was indexed, you will get to know how many pages, HTTP errors, not found pages, URL not found, or redirect on robot.txt not found, URL timeout. Means in case there are any errors, this interface will give you an idea that whether there is any problem in my website. So you will get X-ray of your website in terms of technicality related to Google. And you go to those pages, fix it, come back, resubmit it, and then again. So what all you will get? You will get when it was crawled, how many pages it was crawled, how many pages have meta tags, how many pages have duplicate meta tags, everything you will get over there, over here. Whether your website is verified or not verified, so all these details you will be able to know, and this helps you to effectively manage your website. So this is also, after doing all the process of search engine optimization, you have to submit it back to Google so that Google crawls it. You also get an option in Google saying that what are the error based pages, how many pages have image problem, how many pages have text problem, coding problem. You can go and fix it. So this is an advantage for all of us. So till this level we discussed about on page factors. Now I'll write it down over here. So what all we have discussed, about keyword selection. Then do's for SEO, or you can say must have. right? So properly keyword select, keyword should be selected. Then these keywords should be there in the title, tags or meta tag. Then these things should be there in a header tag. Keyword should be there in content, which we call it content optimization, right? Then it should be there in file name, page file name. We spoke about alt tag, image alt tag. Then we spoke about sitemap. Then sitemap.xml. And then once you have this sitemap.xml, what we will be doing, we'll be submitting in Webmaster or Search Console. Right? Once we do it, so this process of search engine optimization, on-page optimization factor, we almost completed these things. Now we will also have a session in subsequent days about how to identify or how to write proper meta tag. That also we will be doing it, right? And then content optimization, a part of it and all, right? So these things that we have, so these are things related to do's for search engine optimization, okay? Now we will go for off phase. Once you already, you have already done on-page optimization, do's for on-page SEO, right? We must do. Without this concept of SEO is not going to work, right? So we must do these kind of things. So this is what we have discussed so far. Okay. Now we will be talking about off-page optimization. Okay, so we'll be talking about off-page optimization. So what happens once your shop is ready, once your company is ready, what do you do next? You start spreading the words that your website is, your company is ready. So what you have to do, there are various free directories which are available and which are quite resourceful. So you have to identify related to your business. There is a no fixed and fixed format for this. So what you have to do, go to Google, search business directories, free business directories. You will get tons of business directories. Identify few of the websites which are good in terms of content and you submit your website. So what you have to submit? You have to submit the website domain, www.abc.com or xyz.com. You have to submit title description. You have to submit contact details. They ask certain details, so you have to submit those things. And do it very regularly and continuously. So what you have to do, you have to work on directory submission part. Next important thing that you have to work on, local business directory. So what you have to see, if we are doing business only in Hyderabad or only in India, so instead of global business directory, I'll start searching for regional directories or India-based directories. So there are many directories. You do that. Again, earlier Yahoo business directories were there, demos were there. All these things are gone out. So no worries. But yes, there are various local business directories which are there. To try to enlist your businesses over there. You may find IndiaMart, you may find Just Dial. So you try to do all these activities for all the free listings. Don't get hesitant that fee will get attention or not. You keep on doing it. Doesn't matter whether you get outcome or not. It is free. You keep on doing it. But make sure that you are not posting it at a place where hackers are there or any kind of pornographic contents are there or any kind of spammy content are there. Don't submit your content detail over there. Be careful about all those places. Then you have yellow pages. Say for example, Sulekha is in a yellow pages. Just Dial is in yellow pages, online yellow page. Similarly, there are various other yellow pages. If in a URL, you can see yellow pages itself is a domain name. There you can try to see if you can submit it free. If not, then there are other regional yellow pages, directory listings in Hyderabad, in UK, in various platforms. You do Google, create Excel sheet, keep on updating your Excel sheet, maintain that you have submitted all. Then you have to work on link popularity. where you have to work on getting your website link back to your website. Your website link to be added in some of the websites try to work on, which is not that easy these days. Earlier, this was regular practice, but it is not happening in a current scenario. But still, you need to understand as an understanding a history of all these things. You should understand how link building can be done, or it used to happen, right? So what happens? There are two websites. So one website links to B, A website links to B, and in return, B websites links back to A website. Or second option is, so there is nothing called paid option of getting a link back. So what you do, there are mainly barter systems which are available. I give link to your website. In return, you give a link back to my website. So what happens? Number of websites going out of your website link and then coming back. So it somehow equates, right? So that also sometimes it doesn't work out. So this is just a process that you link back to A site, links to give a link to B site gives a link to C site, and then finally more links are coming to C site. So weightage will be more. This is little techy. I'll explain it in a subsequent slides. But just to understand, this is a frame in which link building activity used to happen earlier. Now then, what you have to work on? You have to work on article submission. You have to write article for yourself, for your website, either for client that you are working, or you have to ask article from your client. Now these are the costs which are involved when I was saying that 1500 rupees per keyword or 1200 rupees per keyword. So what you have to do, you have to write content for based on the keyword. Either you write it, get it written. If you are getting it written from someone, of course you have to pay. Even if you are writing, you have the efforts which will be coming into picture. So you have to get compensated. So you write article and you search for free article submission website. There are tons of websites which are quite effective as well. Similarly, online press release. You write some kind of press release, create some kind of noise, some kind of news, and then submit on a press release website. Then you create blog. You have to write some blog related to you. Article is little different than blog, but you can manage both ways. So you create a blog as well, and then you submit your blog articles over there. From blog article, you link back a particular keyword to your website, which will give link back to your website. So that will also increase strength, popularity, and Google also will understand that, yes, your website, more and more link backs are coming, more and more linkages will be coming for your website ranking will start improving. Then you have, what you have to do, if you are new for this, so what you do today after this session, if you get a time, and I think you should experience it, you go to blogger.com or wordpress.com. It's very simple. It's as simple as creating a Word document or creating a PPT. So you can go over there, you put a title, you put a banner image, you put some footer image, you put some content, you will get an option of hyperlinking. So what you do, if I know you want to create, madam, if you want to create it, you can create it with your name .wordpress.com, or Aleem, if you want to create, you can create it like Aleem. If that name is available, you can get it, or Aleem Digital, Aleem.Hyderabad, or Aleem Hyderabad, something like that at .wordpress.com or .blogger.com, and then you can put content over there. So what happens, you'll start seeing and understanding how content are being placed. Now you will also get, the moment you select the word and then you right click on these platforms, it will ask for, do you want to hyperlink? The way that you get an option in Word document or PPT, you want to hyperlink. In a mail draft also, you get an option, do you want to hyperlink? Similarly, you'll get an option over here. You can do a hyperlinking. Hyperlinking is basically providing a link back to a website. You can do that. Then, very effective article syndication websites. Easin article is very, very effective. If your articles are being accepted over there, it's a very worth, very good and plus point for you, right? So but it accepts based on certain quality. So what you do, you get written based on their quality parameters. They have guidelines. Follow those guidelines. If you will not follow you and you submit more than multiple times, they will block you as well. So follow the guidelines and you do it. Go slow, but keep on doing continuous work. One activity in one platform, eventually in 3 months time frame, you'll be able to get good number of traction on all these platforms because of all these. And your search engine ranking will start improving. Then you create a video. Now all of us have a smartphones available or tabs available. Shoot a video, put a proper title tag, create your own YouTube channel, create your own channel, create your own video, upload it on a YouTube. It is giving free of cost. It will ask for what is the title tag, what is the title you want to put, what description you want to put, what in which category you want to publish. It is your own video. Do you, it in which language this is. So everything you put it, you submit it, you'll get a link, and then you post it on all your platforms. So what will happen? You in the description of your video, you can put website link also. You can put your WhatsApp number. So as a business owner, people will start reaching out to you. It has helped me out a lot. So I'm just telling it to you. So you start doing it, it will help you. And believe me, these are free of cost. Last but not the least, you have to ask for reviews from your customers, right? So what you have to do, you have to reach out to the customers or ask your customers to reach out to their customer and then ask them to write about a feedback. Google has a review option, right? Facebook has a review option. And even on Amazon, you purchase a product where sellers' reviews are good. So more and more reviews will come, more and more chances that Google will also push your content, push your page little towards upside of the Google search result, because Google is more careful about how users will behave once they reach to your website, right? And then there are a lot of free tools to populate market. Now understand, you have to create too much of noise on the digital platform. All these platforms are free. You have to create too much of noise. Noise means everyone should start listening. And then, as I mentioned in the first slide, AIDA model, which is attention. To get an attention, you have to do all these things. And this, we call it search engine optimization. Now, so far we discussed about that. I'll be discussing very few. We have few minutes left for 11:30. So I'll be finishing it off. Let's discuss about what you should not do at all. Now, if you are making a website or you are having a website, you must have seen some of the websites. The moment you come to that website, it comes with the jazzy video. Now it asks to click on this video to go to inside of the page. Those kind of pages are not going to rank in Google. So avoid this. You may have a banner, but have the content, because Google reads content. You have to have a content. Lengthier the content is, better chances that your website will rank. Second big mistake that sometimes it happens, or these kind of sites will not rank in Google. Say there is some logo or something written and then say, click here to enter the website. It will take you to some other place. Now, if that is happening, this website will not rank. Third thing is, like, if your website have too much of page not found kind of thing, page 404 error, page not found error. So try to delete those pages right from website. So if more number of 404 page error will be there, that mean to say your website is not up to the mark, and Google will degrade your website. So understand that you have to keep on checking whether your website has any 404 kind of errors or not. And then targeting one keyword or two generic, very generic keyword. I'm like, don't target very generic keywords. Say, for example, leather shoes, very generic. So don't try to do that. So or software. Don't do that kind of thing. If you are into software development, try to say ERP software for manufacturers, or accounting software for medical healthcare units, or accounting software for SMEs, or accounting software for manufacturers. So these kind of things, you try to narrate it. Don't target only with a very small keyword like software or leather or shoes or this kind of thing. Don't do that kind of thing. Big no. And sometimes you will, Google don't read anything in the URL which comes after a special character, mostly. So what you have to do in case that kind of, if your website is dynamic, so there is a possibility your developer may not be aware of all these things. So what you have to do, you have to make him aware that if you are using dynamic parameter in the website, convert that into a static parameter, and all these special characters, question mark, equal to, and Google don't read all these things. So what we recommend, all these things to be replaced by some kind of option, forward slash, replace with forward slash or something like that. So it becomes view product hyphen product ID. So anything after question mark, Google will not be able to read it. So what happens if you are getting it converted? There is a chance that your page, which are coming from dynamic platform, also will get start cached by Google platforms. So these things are more or less about on-page and off-page activity of search engine optimization. So in theory part, if we say, we have covered about search engine optimization. In case you guys have any question, you can unmute yourself and ask me question. We have some time and we can discuss about those questions now. Over to you guys.
Sir, I have a few sites on my mind.
Right.
So I'm just wondering, mainly due to the time constraint, okay. I just want to understand how it flows and everything. But the thing is, I have too many ideas. Like one is clothes designing, designer wear clothes. Mm-hmm. Now I don't know in the present scenario, but earlier, at least a couple of months ago, 3 months ago, mm-hmm. then the jewelry designing and selling of the old stuff that anybody may want to upload whatever they want to get rid of, like eBay, sort of eBay.
Correct.
And the other one is one more. There was another thing on okay. my mind. So all these sites, I mean, will I be able to make it, or your company can take it up and then, you know,
we can
maintain it for us?
Yes, yes. I'm like, we can work out a model where it could be win-win for both of us, and then we can discuss it. We can take it up. That's not a problem.
Sure, because for me to learn and master it and then implement it is going to take time.
True.
So it has a long learning curve, and you know, you have the people and everything.
Right.
And the last one I was talking was like, you know, connecting the tutors and the students.
Right.
Like with the current market, that's the most appropriate one. Right. As my daughter has joined QMath for her math tuition classes.
Correct.
Extra additional math.
Right.
I mean, here there was a lady in the neighborhood, but she is very, very expensive. She charges $45 for a seventh grader for, 1 hour tutoring.
Okay.
So it's very expensive, almost $50. So, mm-hmm. so compared to that, this Indian company, Bangalore-based company, QMath, is really
right.
good. And it works out like $10 a class, and they give eight classes for $80 or $75.
Right.
So which is worth it. And something like that. You know, the tutors should be able to sign in on their own, and the students, and then we maintain that. So how about that? What do you think about that?
We can do that. Look, this, I'm like, because of this current scenario, a big change which is going to happen. I'm like, earlier it was a kind of options which were available only for a few people. Say for example, yeah. when my daughter was there in 10th standard, I have taken Bajus, which was there for 10th, 11th and 12th. But to uh-huh. a certain extent, she continued. But again, it was loss of interest and all. Whatever the topic, right. she was not able to understand. She only used to do that kind of thing. But now it's a compulsion for her that she has mm-hmm. to go through, because schools are locked. I'm like, not opening. So they have to go with that kind of model where it. So bringing people at a platform where audience is also there, and then tutors are also there. It's not that platforms are not available. But still, a lot of people needs a lot of cheaper and easier platforms, because going with a very organized thing, it's a very bulky and all kind of things. So we can work out a model.
Sure. Where
smaller. I'm like, you won't believe for Sanskrit, for Arabic, for Urdu, for regional language, Kannada, Marathi, more tutors are available on online platforms rather than going on a all these e-learning platforms. I'm like, you won't find videos of e-learning. What you will find mostly, if I talk about Byju's, which is prominently promoted, like you'll get maths and science. That's it. What happened to English? What happened? I'm like, all subjects are of the same language, same numbers, right? So there are a lot of opportunities which are there. In case we can bridge something on that platforms, of course, it is something that will that will work out.
Sure, sir. And I know for few people. One of my cousins, I think I discussed already. Right. He's a very international fame, you know, artist, like tabla. He plays tabla at almost at, you know, next to Zakir Hussain, I can say, very famous person.
Okay. Okay.
So he's in the top 10 in the world. Okay. So he's been my kid brother and all that. So he wants promotion for his site. And his site has been hacked. .org has been hacked. Oh. So now he has a site of .com. It had all Japanese characters and all that. So now there is another, I did mention to you that they are into power projects.
Okay.
The CNG manufacturing and all.
Okay.
So that's another site. And other one is my cousin who's doing her own YouTube videos. Mm-hmm. But these are the three companies they're looking for, you know, promotions.
Okay.
So
I think we can discuss it off the track. That's not a problem. Like, we can discuss it whenever you are comfortable. I'm available for some more time, couple of more hours. I'm again available. So once you are done with your household work and all, whenever you are free, you just bring me up and then we'll be able to do that.
All right. Okay.
So we are making a end of this session for today. Anu, I will also ask you to join one of a group that I have created, so that I'll be sharing all the content material, radio material in that group, and then you can also take it.
Oh, sure. Right? Definitely, right. Sir. Send me the link. Thank you.
All right.
Thanks for a nice session. Thank you.
Thank you. Take care.
Very informative. Thank you.
All right. Thank you. Take care. Bye.